Now, to interact with things inside of Roblox, they have a variety of ways you can connect code to your parts. So let's go to Model tab, and under Part, create Block, and make sure the material is something that you can see. I like plastic red because it's very obnoxious, very easy to see. It will make it a little bit bigger just so it's large enough that our character can see it. Now that you have a part, we're going to call this button just so it's very clear what it is. As you start adding a lot of geometry, it's good to keep things organized. So in our button, we're going to add something that allows Roblox to tell us that the player interacted with it. It's called a click detector. This click detector needs to go inside the button, and it kind of acts as a power-up for this part to say, hey, if anybody clicks on any part of this, I'm going to tell the world if they have code for it. The world, in this case, is a script. So we're going to put a script inside the click detector. Now, it doesn't matter that the script's in the click detector. It's just for organizational purposes because we have to target this click detector to get a mouse event. So I'm going to say script, which is a Lua keyword that every script file gets, and it allows it to know, hey, myself, I need to go to my parent. So this script's parent is the click detector. And I'll go ahead and store that in a local variable just to make it a little bit more obvious. So this click detector is basically the table or the object in Lua. So now that you have access to that click detector, you can access its mouse click event. Now see the lightning bolts? That's for all the events you can listen to. We're going to start with mouse click because it's pretty simple to do. If you're on a device, it'd be a touch, but mouse click still works for touch devices, not just mice on desktop computers. And it has a very special method called connect. And connect, using the colon to make sure that you keep scope, allows you to connect a callback function. And anytime the user clicks on that button, it'll call that function. So let's create one up top real quick. Mouse click handler callback, yo. And you can make it shorter, it's up to you. Print, clicked the button, bruh. And we'll take that handler, throw it inside connect. And if I never click, it'll never fire. If I click once, it'll fire once. And if I click 30 times, it'll call this function 30 times. So we're going to hit play here because I want where the camera is to play the game. So we'll play here instead of the spawn point, which is what play does. And we'll walk over to that button we just created. Now watch what happens when my cursor goes over. You see that little finger pointer? That's because the click detector is smart enough to say, hey, if the mouse is over me, I'm clickable. So go ahead and show the pointer to let the player know that they can click on it. So I'm going to hit left click, and you can see it click the button, bro. And that my callback function was handled.